In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a particle logo animation in After Effects using new Trapcode Particular 18. Hope you enjoy the tutorial and let's get to it. First, I'll create a new composition, name it Render, and all compositions created in this tutorial will be in 1920x1080, 30 frames per second and 10 seconds for the duration. Click OK. Then I'm going to create another composition by clicking here. Let's name this one Logo. Then drag and drop your logo into the logo composition. Press S on the keyboard to adjust the scale of the logo if needed. So I'll decrease mine so it has roughly this size. Then I'll create another composition by clicking here. Let's name this one Logo Alpha. Then drag the logo composition into the logo alpha comp. Then make sure the logo comp is not highlighted, so just click away. Then select the rectangle tool up top. Make sure you set fill to a solid color, the actual color does not matter, and stroke set to none. Then simply double click on the rectangle tool, and that will create the rectangle that has the same dimensions as the composition. Let's move this shape layer up above the logo. Then we need to add an effect called Turbulent Displace, so search for Turbulent Displace in Effects and Presets. Add it to the shape layer. Here in Effect Control, set size to 50 and complexity to 10. Now I'm going to press P on the keyboard to bring up position of the shape layer and create a keyframe at the start of the timeline. Let's move the shape layer a bit down like that, so at the point that it does not touch the logo. Then I'm going to move 6 seconds forward and drag the shape layer down until it completely covers the logo. So something like that. So after doing that, we can right-click on the shape layer, select Pre-compose, so let's call this one Shape. Then we need to click Toggle Switches on Mode until you see the Track Matte colon and set the logo's Track Matte to Alpha Matte. And now we get the simple logo reveal. Let's click the composition up top here, New Composition. Let's name this one Logo Invert. Open the Project panel, drag and drop the logo composition here, and then the shape layer above it. And this time, let's set track matte of the logo to alpha inverted matte, and this will be the logo vanish. Right, let's create another composition again, click here. And let's call this one logo stripe. Then we're going to drag the logo alpha comp here twice. Yeah, we need to move the bottom logo alpha layer 5 frames back. So just carefully drag it 5 frames back. And we need to set the track matte of it to alpha inverted matte. And as we do that, we get this like kind of stripe, which you can control like how wide it is by offsetting the bottom logo layer either back or forward in time. So I think 5 frames looks fine. And we're introduced to this weird outline showing through though, and we can easily hide it using the simple choker effect. So search for simple choker and add it to the bottom logo alpha layer and set choke matte either to 1 or 2. Usually 1 works, but in this case I'll set mine to 2. And that outline is gone. Now we click on the composition again, new composition, and let's name this one emitter. Then let's open the project panel and drag and drop the logo stripe here into the emitter comp and also the shape layer above it. Now let's move to 15 seconds and let's offset the shape layer to 15 seconds. Just move it forward in time and set the track matte of the logo stripe to alpha inverted matte. And this is done so that the particles are not constantly emitting. Like if you don't do this, you'll have the particles constantly emitting on the sides and we do not want to see that. So after setting that up, we can go all the way back to the render composition and we're going to drag and drop the emitter comp in here. Like if you don't see this colon, click toggle switches and modes and check this box to make the emitter layer 3D and then hide its visibility from here. Now we need to create a new solid, so layer, new solid. I'm going to name it particles. Now I'm going to search for particular in effects and presets. Add it to the particle solid. Now head over to the Effect Controls panel and the first thing you want to do is expand the emitter, then set emitter type to layer, then particles per second to 500,000, emitter size Z to 50, velocity to 25, let's expand layer emitter, and for the layer we're going to select emitter, let's move a bit forward on the timeline so we can see the particles, right, perfect, let's scroll down to particle, expand. Let's set live to 3 seconds, sphere feather to 0, size to 6, size random 100%, expand size over life, presets and choose the second preset. Let's expand opacity over life, presets and again choose the same second preset. Scroll down to the displace, turbulence field. And set TF displace XYZ to 200 to nicely displace the particles. Let's scroll down to lighting, shadowlets, enable shadowlets. Now we have shading on the particles. So once that's done, we can add extra effects such as vector blur. Search for vector blur, add it to the particle solid. I'm going to set type to perpendicular, amount to 20, and map softness to 20 as well. Then I'll search for sharpen in effects and presets, add sharpen to particles, and set sharpen amount to 100 to make particles appear brighter and sharper. And I'm also going to search for glow, stylize glow, add it to the particles. I'm going to set glow radius to 100. The rest is okay. And after doing that, we can go back to the project panel and drag and drop the logo invert composition below other layers. And now our scene is coming together, as you can see. At this point, we can unlock the layer emitter, then select all four layers, right click, pre-compose. So let's call this one final animation. Right, let's duplicate the final animation. So make sure it is highlighted, go up to edit, duplicate. Press Ctrl D is a shortcut. I'm going to rename the bottom one to reflection. I'm going to right click on it, transform, select flip vertical, and let's move the reflection layer a bit down like so, then press S on the keyboard, uncheck uniform scaling, and set the second value for the scale to -50%, so the logo appears a bit squashed and distorted. Let's move it a bit up like this, then press T and set the opacity of it to 75%, again just to create some contrast between the two. At this point, we can add a floor, or we can create one ourselves. So I'm going to go up to layer, new, solid, call it floor. Then I'm going to search for fractal noise in effects and presets. Add it to the floor layer. And I'm going to set contrast to 200, brightness to -25. Let's set noise type to block, complexity to 3, and that should work fine. Now let's make the floor layer 3D by checking this box. Press R for rotation, set X rotation to 90 degrees, then drag on the Z handle to move it on the Z axis and, you know, drag it down, place it like this. Then I'm going to search for motion tile in effects and resets, add it to that floor layer. Here I'm going to expand output width, so increase that. And then I'm also going to increase the output height until, like, we don't have any gaps in the composition and the floor completely covers the reflection layer, and then check mirror edges. After that, let's move the floor below other layers like this, and we can pre-compose it. So right click, pre-compose, let's call this one floor, and make sure movable attributes is checked, then click OK. At this point, we can hide the floor. Now let's create a new adjustment layer, and place the adjustment layer above the reflection layer but below the final composition, so kind of in between these two. Then search for compound blur in effects and presets, add it to the adjustment layer. For the blur layer, we're going to set it to floor, and as we do that, we can already see the textures of the floor showing through, so you can control the blur amount from here. So I'm going to set mine to 25, and that looks fine. Now I'm also going to add CC glass effect, CC glass, to the adjustment layer, expand surface, bump map, set it to floor. Softness, I'm going to set it to 0. Height to 10 and displacement to 10. So just to give our floor a bit more textury look like this. Now I'm going to search for directional blur in effects and presets. And I'm going to add the directional blur to the reflection comp and set direction to 90 degrees. And I'm going to set blur length to 50. This is done to further distort the reflection layer, so it is not clearly visible because, like, it's supposed to be a reflection, right? And after doing all that, we can add a background. So again, layer, new solid. Let's name this one BG. Place it below other layers. I'm going to search for gradient ramp in effects and presets. Add it to the BG layer. Click the swap colors, so the black color appears at the bottom. Now I'm going to set the start color. I'm going to select the pipette tool and choose something that matches the logo. So maybe this blue color. Then I'll open it up and make it very, very dark, something like that. Click OK and set ramp scatter to 50 to minimize the amount of color bendings. And at this point, all there is left is to add and animate the camera, and we can easily do that. So layer a new camera. I'll select 35mm preset. Make sure these settings are not checked, then click OK. Now we need to make some of the layers 3D, so the final animation, make it 3D, reflection layer, make it 3D, and for the floor layer, we need to check the continuous rasterize icon, this one, because the flow layer inside of the composition is already a 3D layer, so we simply check this box and we're good to go. Now select the camera, press P for position, move the time indicator at the start of the timeline, create a keyframe, and let's decrease the Z position a bit, so maybe negative 2000, just to zoom out. Now I'm going to move to 8 seconds, so that is like 2 seconds past the 6 seconds. That's where our particles stop emitting. So at 8 seconds, I'm going to slightly zoom into the timeline like this to maybe negative 1500. And now we should be ready to preview the animation. So here's our particle logo animation. As you can see, it turned out pretty nice. And the beautiful part about this animation is that if you want to change the logo, all you have to do is open the logo composition, wherever your logo is located, and here drag and drop a different logo. Just make sure you adjust the size of the new logo so it matches the previous logo's size. Then hide the previous logo, and as you go back to the render composition, everything should automatically be adjusted to the new logo that you've added, so you don't need to do any adjustments on your own. Well, the only thing you might need to change is the background color, but that is really nothing. And here's the same particle logo animation done with Starbucks logo. So as you can see, it is very simple to swap out the logo and use a different one. That is it for today. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new in this tutorial. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.